Other jazz stars such as Thelonious Monk and Bud Powell. Bird's all-important cabaret card, his license to work in New York's clubs, was taken away.
He was a full-time musician, but he was also a full-time addict. He knew that well. He knew how to score, he knew how to be safe. That's a full-time life, too. And then he had this third life, living a kind of middle-class suburban dad and husband downtown Manhattan, where everybody, you know, say, hey, here's Charlie, have a beer. And he's just had a smile on his face that everybody loved.
Cab Calloway's article asked, is dope killing our musicians?
Well, Charlie, I would like to get your opinion on something. I read a very interesting article just a few days ago in Ebony Magazine on the byline of Cab Calloway. Did you read it? Yes, and I saw such an article, and I've never read or heard of such a violent, contemptuous thing against musicians of today.
Cab Calloway's article asked, is dope killing our musicians? And made examples of users such as Billie Holiday, Art Blakey, and Fats Navarro, who died a few months earlier. Bird escaped a direct mention in the article, but the authorities began a crackdown on the whole jazz scene.
The FBI was very interested in the likelihood, well, because there was a huge amount of money that the mob, the gangsters, were making out of it. Society, most of society, looked down on it.
I certainly don't think that a musician necessarily plays better under the influence of any stimulus of any kind. I'm pretty sure you agree with me, don't you?
Well, yes, I'd rather agree with you to an extent. Well, nobody's fooling themselves. Never. Anymore, anyway, when you put it that way. And in case an investigation should be conducted, it should be done in the right way. Instead of trying to destroy musicians and their names,